Burnout guys. Burnout cultures. Still in the games room. But I'll tell you something. This is what I'm fucking talking about, right? It's been a right ball ache. Just trying to get this little fucking video done. No. Stop, start, stop, start. Interruptions. Banging on the door. Daddy! No! Just give it fucking 20 minutes! Oh, what can you do? This is why I go to the garage. This is why I have to hide out in the back of a van. Absolute nightmare. But it's Friday. Sorry, Stuart. I can't be able to stop watching that fucking Friday video. Best internet clip of all time, that, Stu. It really is. Absolutely fantastic, mate. Absolutely fantastic. So, we're drinking indoors. And not dinner, girly gin, right? Stick to the man's drink, cider. Fucking gin. I honestly, I don't know anyone that I blokes that drink gin, I'm sorry. That's a new one on me, is that? If you go out on a night out, you don't see blokes drinking gin. No. No, that's for the ladies, that one, I'm sorry. Right, we've got plenty of pickups, but what I've done is I've split it into two, so you'll get half of them in this one and then I've, you know, overspill into the next one. So we'll go through what we've got. We've got some pretty decent stuff. It's not going to be a mega long video. I ain't got time. I'm distracted again. There might be a jump cut anyway. Probably will be a jump cut. Anyways, first off, a magazine. God, what's happening here? Fucking hell, it's all going wrong. Right, so my favourite and probably only magazine, computer magazine that I collected back in day. I did collect comics. You're on about something on comics one the other day, and a lot of people were saying what they used to. I did actually collect comics, but I only, it were mainly Marvel stuff, and 2000 AD. Action Force, the UK Marvel Action Force. I've got a full set actually up in loft. I should show them sometime. The only thing that ruins it is the bloody news agent used to write my mum's name in top. So they're not, you know, mint. But apart from that, I did look after them. They're all in like the sleeves and stuff and folded up. So I've got a full set of Action Force. And what was the other one I used to collect? Marvel. Ghost Rider. Got a lot, yeah, used to collect sort of Ghost Rider Marvel as well. Brilliant comic that. But this, in terms of computer mags, it was just this, and it's actually Yor Sinclair. And I believe this is in great condition. This, I mean, look at that as well. Look at that back street arc. That's what it's about, isn't it? Look at that. I think this is issue, because it's on about back issues here. I believe. It's a real early one. I think it's issue 8. So August 86. I mean, great condition. I mean, even spine hasn't got much wear. The only thing is because I have actually collected Yor Sinclair on and off for years. As usual, get shut of them if they're not getting read, I just, you know, get rid. But the thing is with Yor Sinclair mags, the early ones are actually, the in terms of content, pretty poor. They actually got better for me anyway as they went on. I think there's 228 issues, something like that. I've got a couple. I'll show the other one next time, but I'm gonna try and get a fair few again. But yeah, I mean, so much stuff in here. Really is. What is funny, I noticed, you know, on a lot of these, old advertisements. I mean, they're even advertising for pen. There's like a pen pal section and all sorts. Fucking mental. But there's loads of like advertisements for repair companies to repair your specky. I mean, they're already knackered by August 1986. You know, there's all these companies repairing your spectrums. Fucking hell, they weren't really robust, were they? Mine were absolutely fine. Mine never broke down, I don't think. Original one. I had a 48k. In fact, I think I had a 16k first, then I got a 48k, then I got a 128. But I don't think mine ever packed up, apart from it with a plus two on it with the bloody tapes it used to pack up. That pumping soundtrack on that. Where's I put remote now? Streets of Rage 2. On the BNO! Yeah, you can't beat that. That is what you call. That's what you call a soundtrack, innit? Fucking love this game. Yeah, needed to get this back. So that is the first pickup, which I'm very happy to have. And on the back of that, what I thought I'd get, just to remind me of, you know, the if I'm going to get these sort of magsies. I got the Yours Sinclair Complete Collection on PDF, just purely for reference. Just for reference, really. £2 that. So I thought I'll just get it, just so I know what I'm looking for, because a lot of them don't actually have the issue numbers on. Some do, some don't. It's a bit odd how they worked it. So I think how it goes, you can get issue one in decent shape for about £20. It's the last issue that's the expensive one. I think last time I saw that were about £70, something like that. But yeah, I mean, for £2, fucking hell, absolute no-brainer. Right, a PS4 game, would you believe? I'll show it this way around. A sort of game, is it? It's not really a genre as such, but a game type, if you like, that I've always liked for some reason is winter sports games, and I've always tended to like them on any system, and regardless of how basic or how shit they are, I've always really liked them. And this has been out a while now, but in its original iteration, this is like not an upgrade, but a slight, I suppose it's not an upgrade, expansion to it, but and it's steep. I just love skiing games. Right back to Horace Goes Skiing. So I even liked Horace, but this apparently is, I think it's regarded as best winter sports game on PS4. There's an additional one after this as well. I mean, I got this for fucking dirt cheap, only about £12. And the original, the first sort of version of it that came out, the original one, that's pennies. That is like a fiver game. But I looked at loads of gameplay of it, and you know, oh God, is it a manual? Surely not a manual. First time I've opened, it's just a little pamphlet. And it looks really good, so you can like snowboard, not just skiing, snowboarding, like paragliding, you can do all sorts. The wingsuit, that looks pretty cool. But it's a bit like an open world-ish type thing, or you can choose where you want to compete. So obviously it's like Road to Pyeongchang 2018 Winter Olympics. So I'm gonna get stuck into that. I'm really chuffed with that one. I got some more PS4, but again, I'll show you that on the next vid. Another genre of game that I really like, semi-classed as sports game, is golfing games, actually. I can't play golf. I'm totally shit at golf. I've tried it a few times over here. Always a bit of an Achilles heel with being a left-hander. I always found that were a bit of an handicap. for me when all my mates, back when all my mates started playing when they were about 15, 16, it would, believe it or not, it were quite difficult to get all the left-handed clubs. You know, or they had really decent clubs and you were left with total shit. So it put me off, it put me off. So, you know, so they've turned into half decent players and I'm as shit as ever. But that said, I like playing it on systems, and I always have that. I've always loved golf games, and this one for me is the I won't say it's the best golf game, but it's for, it's probably the most playable one, and it's the one that I've always come back to. Ancient now, an absolute dirt cheap again. Total dirt cheap, pennies game is this, and it's PGA Tour Golf. So I think this was somewhat crazy, like £3.50 including P&P. I mean, you're not going to get better than that, and it is really playable game. It's a fun game. You don't have to, you know, even understand the ins and outs and rules of golf and all that. It's just pick up and play. It really is. I mean, half of these, I bet some of these are even dead, but I remember really showing me age now, Fred Couples. I bet there'd be plenty of people watching this video who have probably never even heard of Fred Couples, but I remember him. I don't remember some of these others, Craig Stadler, Larry Mize, Paul Hasington, no, I don't know them, don't remember them. Never been a massive golfer. Missus actually works for a golf company. And some of her like work colleagues are massive golf fans, they've got to watch it all over the world. And I guess I sort of like, it's a shame that I'm not more into it. Because, you know, she can get all sorts of like, you know, free golfing days and all sorts, but it's not for me. But like playing them. So that cracking little game, and it's another one to add into expanding Mega Drive. So what a lot, I conceded sort of a couple of, I think might have been Scott Sega Zombie and some others had said that 20 is not going to work, Matt, for Mega Drive, is it? And you know, you need to expand it. So look, it cannot, I repeat, cannot go beyond 50 titles. We're going to go to 50, just to be realistic with it. It can't go beyond 50. I'm not even thinking it will happen to go for a full set. 1,000,000% will not happen. No chance. Not bothered. There's too many games. The same reason I got rid of it in the first place. Too many games that'll just sit collecting dust that'll never get played. It's not going to happen. So, but I won't be, that's it, I won't be realistic saying 20. There's just too many good, such as PGA Tour Golf. Right, a couple of PS1. I hear you groan. No, not my PS1. So again, going back to the Winter Olympics. Now, you can get this game on N64. I don't know it. Is it N64? Is it SNES? I think it's N64. Yeah, it will be N64, won't it? Yeah, it will be. And do you know what? Of all the games, PS1 games recently that I've picked up, I've put most time into this. Again, purely because I just love Winter Olympic games. And it's a Konami title, and it's Nagano Winter Olympics 98. Absolutely cheap as chips again. And the reason I got it for is technically, if I'm going for that first 1,000, it's pretty much there or damn it. So it's actually 0000999. Can't remember what number a thousand was. Thousands is a pricey one, a real pricey one. But this, so we're aiming to get 1,000, and I fucked that off. I can't afford that. So I've got a 999, nice cheap one. But I tell you what, I must have put a good 10 hours into this game since picking it up a couple of weeks ago. Managed to get gold on the ski jump, playing as Eddie the Eagle Edwards, obviously. Some of them are pretty tricky. Snowboarding were good, downhill were good. A couple of iffy ones like speed skating, but cracking little game that, and again it's only like a fiver. Only a fiver. So yeah, I really enjoyed them anyway. This one here were one that Eddie the bastard had said, you know, these bloody cardboard weird what can we describe them as? They're like oddball, weird cardboard PS1 games that are not fucking cheap or easy to find. Or they're not easy to get for a good price anyway, put it that way. So this bastard here, I will say though, it's been worth the wait. It has been worth the wait in the condition that it is, but this has been a real pain in the absolute ass to get hold of. I just weren't willing. I wasn't willing to pay the price that you know what it's asking. So I thought I had paying that. So I just put like a safe search thing in, and finally, one popped up for an half decent price, and just snapped it up. And it was one of them where it's come through, and it's like, you know when condition sometimes blows you away by how good it is. It looks way better than, you know, in real life than it did in the pictures. So many times it's the opposite way around, isn't it? But this is about as good as you're ever going to get. Anyway, too much waffling. It's the NBA, Total NBA 97 with a rubberized weird cover. Absolute pence to buy the standard box one. But this has been good, what, 35, 40 quid, and I'm like, no, I ain't paying that, I'm sorry. There's not loads of them kicking around. It's not hard to find, but there's not loads kicking about, and I bet there ain't loads in this condition. I mean, I don't know if you can see that, but the actual box is fantastic. There is barely a mark on it. I don't think this has really been, you know, I defy anyone to find a cardboard, PS1 cardboard, what we're talking, 19 what? Where do I fucking know? Yeah, 97. You know, you talk 23, getting on nearly 25 year old. I defy anyone to find one in better condition. I mean, look at that manual. That is as good as you're gonna get. It really is. You know, when you can tell, can't you? When, you know, like we've said before, when you're new, and some pages when they're creaking because they've never even been opened. That's what it's like. Well happy with that. So I managed to get that for 15 quid. So well chuffed. But on playing it, I'm not that impressed with it. I don't know if is it NBA Extreme, the one you were so showing on yours, Stu. I don't know if, I'm hoping that's a better game, because I'm thinking of picking that up in the hope that it's better than this. This just seemed a bit clunky at best, and the sort of like the defence side of it were, I didn't enjoy it at all. But it's a collector's piece, innit? It's nice to have a collector's piece, so I'm going to put that in a box protector. The story with the Dreamcast is it was literally the point in time when I completely moved away from gaming. We've all got that. You know, I'm sure there's a system or a point in time in the timeline when most of us have dipped out of gaming. You know, like girls come on scene, drinking and this, that and the other. And it was right smack bang when the Dreamcast were released, and I just had no interest whatsoever. And it's a system, to this day, I've never even thought about. But I was pondering, you know, thinking, shall I get GameCube? I'm like, no, because the thing that put me off with the GameCube was, there's too many dupes on the PS2, and I've gone down the PS2 route. I mean, I know apparently a lot of the GameCube versions are better than the PS2. I accept that, but it just didn't have enough appeal. So I thought, you know, let's have a bash at this GameCube thing. It's got a few people said it's quite doable to get a full set. I'm not saying I will, but it's quite doable. It's one of them you can just chip away. And they're 200 and odd again. I've got a list somewhere. But I thought, you know what? If I'm going to get the system at least, I want to get something a bit different. And this is a bit different. I mean, admittedly, I've overpaid for it. That was a standing joke. Like I fucking do have everything, don't I? Matt the dipstick, done it again. He's overpaid. But it's nice. So it's this lime green one. Yes, it is a reshell. After asking quite a lot of people in the know, apparently it's got the better original internals of the Yamaha ones, I believe it is, that are a little bit more hardy. So I'm happy with that. It's got the a crystal green controller, different shade of green though. These were official, so that's nice to have that. It's got all the cables. Now I'd said to Rob the other day, Stu's mate Rob, and various other people actually asking about this RGB SCART, is it? I'm guessing this is original. Oh, it might. I don't know. I don't know jack shit about Dreamcast, to be honest. You can get some real decent cables for those things, but they're quite pricey. I'd show Dylan one picture of these, like a Dreamcast RGB some box, like pushing 100 quid, and he showed me one that's even better than that. I just want someone to get an half decent picture. I'm not massively invested in getting the best of the best for this system, to be honest with you. I'll probably more concentrate on the game side of it. We've got what I presume is, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm guessing this is like a, is it a controller extension cable because it's a male and female? Who knows? But it's good to go. The reason why I hadn't even tested it is because up until midweek I couldn't really test it, or I could have done with that, but I mean faffing about. But what I'm really chuffed to have got is this, which I've been after a long time, and it's this Bandridge 5-way SCART switcher. So finally now we can get a lot of these systems, because I brought this back from my mum, so I took a lot to my mum's, but this is landed back. Didn't think this through at all, did I? The Jap Saturn, so that's back now, so that can get hooked up as well. So I'm going to get all these systems connected up to this Bandridge, but really happy with this. And these are not that easy to source even out, and they're quite pricey, so I think a lot of people's cottoned on that, you know, they're needed for gaming and stuff. Don't know much of what originally, but this one's bagged. In fact, it could even, I think it's actually new. He did say on the thing it's never been used, so I mean, I won't horrify you with what I've paid for it, but they're not particularly cheap. This is certainly this 5-way one. I think you can get a 3-way one that's a bit better in terms of cost, but yeah, they're not the cheapest. But what can you do if you want stuff connected? So I'm going to connect the Dreamcast, the Saturn, and I want to get either the American SNES or the Famicom set up as well. on that note, I also managed to source one of these American SNES pads. Really happy to get this. Now this turned into a trickier process than what I thought it would be as well. Not many of these about, and I'd asked someone, I think it was Dana. There is a slight difference between these and the European one and Jap one, is that the X and Y buttons are actually dished as opposed to domed. Didn't know that, because so when this landed I thought, is it kosher? But yeah, they are, it is a genuine. The only problem is with it, I mean, I got this for a really good price. It is quite, I don't know if you can see, it is quite a bit yellowed. Probably don't pick it up on camera, but the back has yellowed. I mean, it can happen. I mean, it could easily be the back off another one for all I know, but I know these, it's really weird, isn't it, with SNES plastics, how some yellow and some don't. But I got this for a tenner. Really happy with that, because I've seen these go for pushing 25, 30 quid if you're not careful. There's not that many about, so you just got to keep an eye out for when one comes up and grab it. But anyway, happy to get that. I mean, I haven't even tested it yet. Hope it works. So that's, I think that's about it for now. I don't want to show you all the other stuff. I'll leave that for another time. Also, I haven't forgot about the competition. So what I've been trying to do is come up with something a little bit different. It might bomb, I don't know, it might not. You know, if I do one and it, you know, there's been no interest in it, or there's people say it's shit, I'll leave it. But I just thought I'll just give it a try. So I've been trying to sort of put that together this week. It will be for this. So the first competition will be for this this Famicom bloody whatever the hell it is. It's worth entering when I'll do. Let's go for next vid. Let's say next vid will be the actual competition vid. I'll save the pickups vid for afterwards, but we'll do the next vid, can be the competition vid for this. It's worth entering because I haven't opened this. It is literally brand new as I got it. I haven't took it out of the box. I was contemplating, like I said before, when I got it, to keep it as a shelf piece, but I've seen them on eBay now as from UK sellers, nearly 100 quid. So it might be worth it. And if you have got a vested interest in this old Nintendo Famicom stuff, then it's worth having in your collection. I particularly don't really do much for me. I'm more interested in box, if I'm being honest. But I'm happy to have that as a competition prize anyway, and we'll see how it goes. But yeah, just give us a few days just to put finishing touches on you know, on the criteria competition, and we'll run it and see how it goes. And you might have a chance of winning it. Right, how long we've been running? Is it there? Oh, I don't know. In a second lot. I think that's it for now. I'm gonna have a few more tins. I love Fridays. I can't dance still. I wish I could dance like that guy, mate. Best dancer ever, that fucking guy, man. Top lad. What's he called? Mustafa? Mustafa or something, mate. Fucking absolutely. I've saved that video now for whenever I need cheering up, that video's getting played. Forever. For all time. Right, guys. I love you and leave you. Enjoy your weekend. Or if you've watched this towards the back end of the weekend, I hope you've had a good weekend. I might watch it through a week. I hope your week's going well. Whichever. But thanks ever so much for watching. Please like, share, sub, comment. Call me a twat if you want. It don't matter. Water for ducks back. Don't matter to me. But thanks for watching, guys. Really, really, really do appreciate it. And check back soon to... have a bash at trying to win this this Famicom. Okay guys, nice one. Long live the retro.
Their lives again, 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 their l